Yeah, I'm here.
Where are you? I can't see you.
Hey, look around. Look, I'm holding the light. Look. Oh, get off my foot. Oh,
okay, I see you. Where's the cameraman? I can't see the camera.
Hey, cameraman, we're over here. Look. Oh, hey.
There you are.
Hey, this is Pastor Sam, and this is Mr. John Steinklauber.
Hi.
We're out here at Uncle Bob's pumpkin patch. He's got a corn maze behind us. These leaves, you see, this is real stalks of corn. All behind us is a whole field, and there's just a very narrow maze, and we're going to try to make our way through it tonight in the dark. Is that exciting? Is it scary? A little bit scary. Hey, let's go ahead and check out the trail. See if you can follow us.
I'll follow you, man. Oh.
This is kind of scary.
Kind of dark.
Oh, yeah? Kind of. Glad we've got a light.
Yeah, wow. Me too.
Some of the corn is falling over here.
Uh-oh.
We'll have to push our way through. Oh, a spider.
Hope he's not a big spider. That is a big spider.
Yeah. Let's see. What a maze. This is like being in a jungle. I wonder if there's any crazy creatures out here.
Crazy creatures?
Yeah.
Like me?
Like, yeah, you count as a crazy creature.
I don't know about that.
Oh, it's kind of wet. Do you feel all this water on it?
It smells like popcorn out here. Sort of like wet popcorn.
It smells kind of like... You must be right. Oh, you gotta get down real low to get through this part. Oh, I can hardly see the trail, Mr. John.
I can't see nothing.
Just follow the light.
How do we know we're going the right way?
Well, we don't. It's a maze.
Oh.
Just follow the light if you get lost. Hey, we're at a crossroads. We can either go this way. It goes around the corner there. Or we can go over this way through those little bushes. And the trail goes off to the left. Man, this is a big decision we've got to make. Hey, you know, I was just thinking when I was telling you to follow the light. What would happen if we ran out of fuel?
I don't know.
I mean, that would be pretty scary. We're out here in this dark field.
It'd be really crazy dark.
I hope our lantern has enough gas in it. You know, sometimes these things run out of gas.
That's a handsome guy.
Hey, where? I don't see one. There he is. I see him. He looks like Pastor Sam. Oh, there's another handsome guy. Looks like Mr. John.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, I was just thinking, if this did run out of fuel and we were standing here in the dark, what would we do?
I don't know. But you just put fuel in it, right?
Yeah, I think we won't run out, but it's never a bad idea to have a backup plan. Do you have any matches we could start a fire?
We might burn down all the corn.
Oh, good call. I got it. Did you bring your car into the cornfield with us? We could just turn on your headlights.
No, I forgot. I didn't do that.
That won't work. We could catch a bunch of lightning bugs.
What if they bite us?
Good call. Wait, I remember. Look, I brought my flashlight. There it is. Hey, what kind is this?
I think it's a, is that a mag light?
Yeah, it's a mini mag light. These are good flashlights. Hey, whoa, this is one of the best kind of flashlights you could have. But you know what, Mr. John? Today in Journey Kids, we're learning about worship. We're learning that worship is giving God everything. Giving God your all. And I was just thinking about this here flashlight, you know? If I had this in my pocket, and the fuel ran out, we were standing alone in the dark, and if I forgot my batteries, wouldn't do us any good, would it?
No, probably wouldn't.
Do us any good at all.
Be like, you know, nothing.
It would be like not having a flashlight at all. You know what, Mr. John?
What's that?
There's a lot of flashlights out there, and they all look like flashlights. You can tell it. When you look at them, you can tell that's what they are. But if they didn't have something powerful inside of them, they wouldn't work. It wouldn't be a real flashlight. It would just look like a real flashlight. Well, today we're teaching the kids about worship. And you know what, kids? It's a lot like flashlights. When you go into churches and you look around, you can always see people praising the Lord. You can tell because sometimes they're singing, sometimes they're clapping their hands.
Sometimes they're jumping up and down.
Sometimes I've seen that too. And it really looks like they're praising the Lord. But you don't know if they really are or not unless you can see inside, like a flashlight. If there's not something powerful inside driving them to worship God and praise God, then maybe it just looks like worship. It's a good thought to think about. You know what, boys and girls? The Bible teaches us that unless our worship is giving God everything, it only looks like worship. It would be like a flashlight with no batteries. Wouldn't do us any good to get out of this cornfield in the dark.
Mm-mm.
Today, I want you to listen close. While the preaching is going on, during the Bible time, I want you to think about it. Are you willing to give God your all? He's looking for true worship. True worship is giving God your all. Something powerful on the inside, coming out to praise and love God. And it only happens when you give Him everything.
Everything. Well, batteries included.
Batteries included. Hey, let's see if we can make our way out of this field. And we'll see you guys in... maybe it was that way. I don't...
Maybe... Do you know?
I'm not sure.
Well, see ya.
Okay, hopefully we'll make it out so we can see you guys in Journey, kids. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Oh. It's dark. I can't see.